Hello friend, today I am discussing about water quality assessment system, and this water quality assessment system is based on Internet of Things, and we are using different smart sensor for water quality assessment. Basically, water quality assessment is done manually on laboratory using chemical process, but in this lecture we are doing we are working on the water quality assessment, and we are using smart sensors, and this is the research project, and basically this was funded by USERC, and this work was done in association of Uttarakhand Science Education and Research Center, and the project investigator of this water quality assessment system are Professor Dilesh Pant, Professor and scientist Dr. O.P. Nautiyal, and myself Dr. Ashutosh Kumar Bhatt, and my team has worked on it, and some of my student has worked in it, and we have also applied for patent, and we have granted the patent application number. So what is the water scenario all over the country? So first I will discuss about that, and then I will come to how we did our work in this water quality assessment system. So basically in context of the Uttarakhand, lakes, basically lakes are the lifeline. The initial idea came from the Nainital lake, and we have seen sometime the lake of Nainital is going very much polluted during the season of summer season, when the tourist activities are on the peak at Nainital. So that time it was going very polluted, and the water level of the lake is decreased at that time, and so many of the organization, many of the NGOs, and many social activists always worried about the water quality of the Nainital lake. So administration also worried for its quality, because lots of lives and lots of people depends on the lakes. So idea came from the Nainital lake, but in Uttarakhand, the Nainital district is also, sometimes we can call it lake district, and there are number of lakes in Nainital district, and in Uttarakhand many lakes, dams and rivers are there in Uttarakhand, and lakes are also lifeline of Uttarakhand, and these lakes are the big water resource of Himalaya also, and it drives Himalayan ecology, and sometime this Uttarakhand is called water tower of Asia, and lots of river and Himalaya is also in Uttarakhand, so it is a water reservoir, and it is Devbhoomi, and we produce and provide water to other states of the country. So water is one of the essential natural resources required for sustaining the life and environment. There are number of lakes in hill area of Uttarakhand. These lakes are very big water reservoir of Himalaya and play important role for Himalayan ecology. The management of the lake water quality is major environmental challenge. So as we know that lots of lakes are in Uttarakhand, so their management and their water management, their quality management, it really a tedious job, and we have to manage it. And in hill area, the scarcity of drinking water is very vast, and sources are limited. We can also see the sources are very limited, and day by day the sources are going to pollute due to, and the scarcity of the water is also very worse at this time. This is in an alarming situation, and due to the over construction in hill area. It has very and Uttarakhand also in a very difficult geography also. And alarming 80% of the India's surface water is polluted. If we see the whole country scenario, then 80% of the India's surface water is polluted. A latest assessment of the Water Aid, international organization working for water sanitation and hygiene. And most of the pollution is directly consuming the water without any filtering process. So most of the population of India is very poor, and they are directly drinking polluted water sometime. So they don't have any filtration process, and the medium family and higher income group, they are using the filters and high-end filters, but the poor population don't have any filtration process. So to ensure them the good quality of water, this project is very important. Indian government is investing approximately 8,588 crore rupees on Himalayan ecology, and establish a separate ministry to clean Ganga river named as Namami Gange. So a separate ministry has started, and thousands of crores of fund has been released for Namami Gange. And since last 5 to 6 years back, it has been started. 6-7 years back it has been started. So government is doing lots in this direction, and that's why we thought that we should work on this project. The present water quality assessment is very tedious. We all know that it is very tedious and time consuming process, because the manual and just so lab testing is very difficult. That particular operator or person, chemist, will go and he will take the sample and then test on the lab. Then daily he will display that data on his website. So it is very tedious and time consuming, and one employee is fully we have to employ one employee, we have to recruit one employee which is fully dedicated for this work. So this is time consuming as well as cost, not cost effective. And there is no low cost automatic water quality assessment system. We have seen this fact that there is no any low cost automatic water quality assessment system is there in the market. So that's why we thought that we have to work on this direction. And basically it was for lakes, and we have planned to establish water quality assessment devices in Uttarakhand if government will permit us, and if other NGOs and other department will permit us and they allow us, then we will establish them in different area. So we have done a little trial on water quality assessment, and we also have the problem of eutrophication in the lake. Algae, and these algae consume the oxygen. You can see the diagram. Eutrophication leading cause of impairment of the fresh water, and due to this algae and due to this eutrophication, it is a problem for the fish also. So according to the fish, we have to see the quality of the water. It is very, very important. So underwater life underwater, for the life of underwater to we have to judge the life of underwater, we require this device. And you can see here we have lots of algae, and these algae, when these algae die, then it comes to the bottom of the lake, and the decay algae will consume more, and it hold more oxygen. So this is also a problem of eutrophication also. So we have to judge the water quality. It is very important to judge the water quality. So these are the many 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 things. That's why we thought about this project. So you can see we have been the famous lakes of this Uttarakhand. We have been the lake of Nainital, lake of Bhimtal, Sat Tal, Nakucha Tal, Dodi Tal, Pahana Tal, Kedar Tal. Actually, this is the picture of Bhimtal Lake, but wrongly written here, this one. So, we have lots of lakes in this region, and lakes of Uttarakhand hills are in Uttarakhand state called Lake District. Nainital is also called Lake District. There are under restoration with fund and provided by the National Lake Conservation Plan of the Government of India. The lakes are following. So sometimes we don't have more fund to judge the quality of lake. So that's the problem also, that we cannot properly judge the quality of water of lake. So this device, we have tried to develop the device which is low cost device. So however, in up to some extent we succeeded to develop a low cost device. So I will explain in later slides. So we have tried that these lakes should connect with our computer system, and each lake, the device established in each lake will send the quality of the lake water to the system center server. So this was the basic idea, and this was the idea, and we thought that we have to collect water quality like temperature, pH value, turbidity, conductivity, dissolved oxygen, nitrogen, phosphorus, and TDS. So many parameters are of the water, but in the first phase we have taken some of the sample, and these parameters are temperature, pH value, turbidity, and TDS. Basically, we have taken four parameters, four parameter. In this trial, we have successfully collected all four parameters, and the machine is working properly. And later phase, if government or any NGO, they will demand accordingly. So we will increase the parameters which we are collecting from the water. So this is the design of our system. This is water reservoir, and these are the parameters. Sensor means temperature sensor, pH sensor, TDS sensor, turbidity sensor, and we can also use color sensor, but this time we don't have used any color sensor. We have used TDS and turbidity sensor. So this will the data of sensor will goes to microcontroller, and LCD panel on microcontroller will display the value of these parameter, and through GSM will send it to the monitoring center. So this was the diagram or system, and you can see this also. So we have used Arduino Uno, and through GSM we are sending it to the data server, center server, and these are the different sensors which have been attached with the Arduino Uno. So this is the complete diagram. Basically, we are having this complete diagram, and in future we thought that we will apply a neural network. However, in different research group, in our different different research group are working on that. One of the our student or researcher is doing ANN based quality assessment in Ganga River, and one of our team member is doing this one on Nainital Lake also. So this was the basic idea. So this is the Nainital Lake, and sensor, we have the sensor inside the Nainital Lake and Bhimtal Lake, and through these sensor we will collect pH sensor. Through pH sensor we will collect the pH value, temperature sensor we will collect the temperature, turbidity, and we will have the battery, and one more sensor is there also, that is TDS sensor. So by these sensor we will collect the value, and this value will transfer to the Arduino through Arduino Uno, and it will be moved through GSM module to our system, to our center server. It may be system, computer system, or our mobile also. We can see it on mobile and other smart devices. So in this order we have the data. So without going to the river or without going to the lake, we have tested many times, and still we have not installed it on Nainital Lake, but in future we can install it if government allows us. So we have taken lots of trial. We have taken data from Kosi River, we have taken data from Bhimtal Lake and other reservoirs, and right now we are working on cold water fisheries and we have installed this device on cold water fishery this time. So this is the basic model, and after collecting this data we can have lots of data, and by this data we will apply artificial neural network, and we can forecast the quality of water, the quality of whole year of the water. We can classify the water, we can forecast the water quality of in every season. So this is the complete model, water quality model, and this is very very easy method, because without going on the river or lake, we are directly connecting the data on our mobile, and every minute and every hour we will have the water quality. These parameter we will have, and things speak is the framework through which IoT framework through which we are collecting the data. And now you can see the different sensor, like PS sensor. So this is the model of PS sensor which we have used in our model or system. And temperature sensor, this is the small temperature sensor. Its cost is very less. You can buy it approximately ₹100, and on bulk cost will also be decreased. And TDS sensor, this will be TDS sensor. And this is we have also used TDS sensor in our system or device. And Arduino Uno board, this is Arduino Uno board. Its cost is very less. So initially its cost is around ₹2,200, but according to market price, it will be it may be decreased or increased. So accordingly it may be. So this is the GSM shield, and through GSM shield we send the data to remote machine through Arduino GSM shield, and we have one LCD panel where we can see the quality of water. And these are the different sensors. You can see here temperature sensor, TDS sensor, LCD module, and GSM module, Arduino, turbidity sensor, pH value sensor. So we have different sensor as well as different tools we are using on this on designing this complete model. So you can see here we are taking data from the river as well as from different lakes. So these are the output when we have developed the complete system. This is our Arduino, and we have GSM and different sensors. These sensors are deep down the water, and all the data is all the sensors are sensing the data, and this is displayed on our LCD panel, and we same time we can redirect this data on mobile phone or desktop or laptop, so any smart device. So this is the physical view you can see here also. So these are the data which we can see here, and this is also one of the physical view. where we can see the data, and this is the another LCD panel, and we can use here mobile LCD panel also. So we can see here, this is called written here water monitoring, and temperature is this, turbidity, pH value, TDS value. So through different sensor we are getting these values. So and you can see the front view of this panel, and the device, when we have completely developed the device, when this device is properly working, and up to 6 months we have tested the device and implemented the device in different area. So then we have inaugurated this device by Honorable Chief Minister of Uttarakhand, and these are the photographs, some photograph of the inauguration. But this is the compact device and very lightweight device, and we can carry this device easily from one place to another place. And this is another view of the system, and so this is the snapshot. So but we have lots of challenges in device, in this device also, because this system is a very very effective system, and as the time, as per the time, as we are in the era of IoT, Internet of Things, we are in the era of big data, cloud computing. So remotely we are collecting the data without going any without physically going to the site on river or any water reservoir. We are directly collecting the water quality from there, and we can develop water atlas of the state as well as country. If we have such a cost effective device, then we can install each device in each river as well as lake, and we can directly collect the data. In case of any river has a polluted water, then it will display the alarming situation, or it will display it will blink of at that position where we have polluted data. And we thought that it can be implemented in Namami Gange project. My idea is that suppose we have fixed the device location, suppose we have installed the device in every 10 kilometer in river Ganga, from Haridwar to Varanasi, suppose. So in every 10 kilometer, and the costing of each device is around 2000 to 3000 approximately. And suppose we have 100 different devices in each location, each after each 10 kilometer or 20 kilometer, suppose 50 devices from Haridwar to between Haridwar to Varanasi or Allahabad, and suppose all the devices are giving the values of water quality values up to the mark. Suppose some of the device, suppose 5 or 10 devices are sending the polluted water signal. So we can see there, and we can inspect that physical location, that some organization or some company is sending polluted water in the river Ganga or not. So we can directly find out that particular location, and we can pinpoint that particular location where the water, polluted water, is coming on the river. So this way we can help to Namami Gange project, and even in the river also, in the other river also, and other lakes also. Suppose in any lake is giving their signal of polluted water by this device, then we can do the preventive action, how the lake is going to pollute it, and we can physically inspect or see the actual position. So this is the idea behind all this And this is very good and project, and but challenges are lots of challenges are there. The device should be more compact and to be fit within the ball, and we have power supply to the device in both mode, DC and AC mode, but we have also used their other power supply medium also, and it can also be optimized in future, and we need to better power source also, and we should also optimize it, and interfacing with the GSM seal, we have to drop the device into public zone, and GSM interfacing have to be implemented, and efficiency of each sensor need to be checked. However, we have checked the device up to 6 months and it is working properly, and this we have different small sensor, and this is the question, how many places the device should be installed. We can replace the device, suppose in particular place we have established the device, but we can, according to the requirement, we can replace it, and these are the sub challenges, and it can also be optimized, and so these are the different challenges, and we can optimize it, and we can improve the device, and other researchers can improve it, and we have applied this device for the patent. We got the patent application number, and very soon it will be granted. We are expecting that. So thank you very much, and thank you.